I wrote this spoken word. I hope you guys enjoy it. I call this truth. There's a truth that's deeper than experience. It's beyond what we see or even what we feel. It's an order of truth that separates the profound from the merely clever. It also divides the fake from the real. And usually we're helpless in the face of it. Every time this truth seems to come our way, and the cost of having it and keeping it in our life is more than some of us will ever be willing to pay. Now see, a lot of you may not know my past, because now what you see is pretty much what you get. And I've worked so hard and come so far to be who I am today that for me to go back, I'd have to be a complete idiot. I learned that I had to die to myself to live in order for me to have my spirit awaken. I also know how it feels to be forgiven and forgiven, what it means to be not forsaken. You see, for years I've been aching, heavily medicated just so I can ease my pain. Blocking out the reality of me losing my grip on life and trying to find the right person to blame. Over the years, I managed to become a complete failure. People like you and I call it casualties in the game. All because I tried to pick up the pieces of my life all by myself instead of calling out for Jesus' name. And it's insane for me to say that if I knew then what I know now, then maybe some things would be different. Because ever since I was a kid, I knew the difference between right and wrong and still ended up being just as ignorant. But life is not about getting it right. And it's not about having no regrets. And it's impossible to understand this truth that I learned unless you surrender your life and jump deep into its depths. You see, there's a saying that says you can lead a horse to water, but it's not your job to make him drink. The truth is, I can stand here and talk to you guys until I'm blue in the face, but it's impossible to change the way you think. The truth is, when you've had enough, then you've had enough. You got to be tired of being sick and tired. And you got to stop worrying about what others think about you, bro. It's not the way a man's brain should be wired. You see, we seek the acceptance of love because love is the only cure for loneliness, shame, and sorrow. So desperately, we seek it from others instead of going to the one who gives us tomorrow. And some of us have hidden the truth in our hearts for so long that only loneliness helps you find it again. While with others, the truth about ourselves can be so hurtful at times that only shame helps you live with them. The truth is, you know the truth. And God has a plan for every single one of you. It's written in Jeremiah 29:11, and there's a few other verses that say the same thing too. The truth is, he will turn your world upside down if only you will allow his spirit to come through. Then, and then only, will you be able to understand what's true.